This is Ms. Barnacle again, and this is our last section for chapter one or module one. And it talks about order of operations. And in the previous module, I said that we were going to do please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. That is just an acronym for the order of operations and the way that you are supposed to do things. If you look at the slide, you'll see that it says P parentheses. We do what's inside the parentheses first. But parentheses are not just your normal parentheses. They could also be the brackets or a square root symbol because they're all grouping. Okay, then you do E for exponents, M for multiplication, D is division, A is addition, S is subtraction. Now, multiplication and division are done in order from left to right when you're working out the problem, just like you read a sentence, as well as adding and subtracting. Those are also done from left to right, depending on which one comes first in the problem. And in the books now, they use this acronym, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. It just helps people keep straight what you're supposed to do first. But notice what it says, you do not always work a math statement like you read a word problem. It just depends on what comes first. If you have grouping, then you do that first and then you work your way out, okay? I'm going to work a few examples up here on the board for you. So let me change to the board. Okay, and I put a couple of examples. The first one we're going to do is 4 plus 5 plus 2 to the second power. So when you talk order of operations, P is parentheses. Nowhere in this problem do I see parentheses, brackets, no square root. So I can skip that step. Next, we look for E, exponents. Well, I do see that 2 has an exponent, so I want to work that out or evaluate that first. So I'm going to bring down the 4 plus 5 because I'm not ready to use that yet. And so I have 2 to the second power. Well, a couple of modules ago, we talked about exponents, and we said that 2 squared means 2 times 2, so that would be 4, okay? Now, you look for multiplying and dividing. I don't see any in this problem, so our next thing we do is adding and subtracting from left to right. So when I look at this, all I see is addition, which is nice, so I just add. 4 plus 5 is 9, and 9 plus 4 makes 13. So the final answer to this question is 13, okay? Now, the next problem I worked out, I'm going to work out for you, has a couple of group symbols. Parentheses, it's got that in there. It's also got a square root. So we want to make sure that we do that first. So this is 2 times, the dot means multiplication, okay? And we want to take the square root of 49. Well, the square root of 49 is 7 because 7 times 7 makes 49. And then I see these parentheses over here. These parentheses mean negative 3 times 4. That is what the parentheses represent in that particular set of part of the problem. So I have now gotten rid of the parentheses, I've gotten rid of the square roots. Now I'm going to look at multiplying and dividing from left to right. So when I look from the left to the right, I see multiplication here, and I also see multiplication here. So I want to make sure I do my multiplying first. So that would be 2 times 7, which would be 14. Bring the subtraction sign down because I'm not ready to use it yet. And then 3 times 4, and that would be 12. Now I've gotten down to nothing but subtraction, so that's my last step. And that leaves me 14, take away 12, leaves 2. So the final answer to that problem is 2. Okay, now there are other ones that are worked out in this module. I've worked out several examples for you on the rest of the papers, so you could print those out and have several examples to look at. Okay, and this is the end of this lesson, and I hope that you have enjoyed module one, and module two is coming up shortly.